Alright guys, so it's 5 a.m. on Friday. I'm about to get on a plane and head to Massachusetts. It's 41 degrees here in Florida. I've been told there's about 3 feet of snow in Massachusetts. And I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I'm pretty apprehensive because I don't have clothes for this. I definitely don't have clothes for this. Low-key terrified, but kinda excited at the same time. Pray for me. Alright, so Bama'S Airport Chronicles. Our flight is completely overbooked. And I'll be the dead last one to get on the plane, if I get on the plane. So, you guys might hear a seminar tomorrow, you might not, because I might not make it into the cold to do it first. Man, I believe Canuck will. And so I finally got on the plane, and I actually
Hercules.
Ended up in the second row, so I don't know how I made it here, but it's a good day to have a good day. Can someone please explain to me why this happens? We have not even started boarding yet. Everyone is standing in my personal space. We're literally going all to the same place. Right? What's up guys, just made it into Connecticut. I know I said I was going to Massachusetts, but I looked you live. Landed in Connecticut, and then I'm gonna hop over the line and get to Massachusetts. I also put on my headband. I didn't want my big forehead to get too cold, you know what I'm saying? Gotta take care of the babies. About to meet the guys and Rich. They're about to pick me up from the airport, so let's get it.
Our favorite place on earth.
Alright, so just got back from eating some fried rice. You like that? That champion mindset, swaggity swag, keeping me warm and cozy. Look at my cheeks, rosy. Yeah, so coming back to pick me up at 5, gonna go to the gym, train a little bit. Trained back last night. Probably gonna train some buys and tries, just do some curls with girls. That's what all you guys are into. So, with that being said, yeah, so it's like legit snowing. Snowing! Okay, so if you guys haven't gathered, I am not used to the snow. I am from South Carolina. I moved to Gainesville, Florida recently. I like warmth. I like being warm. I don't know how to function. Buffalo was cold enough, but I wasn't outside for very much. But I'm about to go on an adventure, so I'm going to take you guys with me on how Bama is going to handle the snow. These guys, like, off of Amazon, they're some type of tactical halfway waterproof boot. I think they're Free Soldier or something on Amazon. I've worn them a couple times. Like to take them with me. Just on trips like this, you know, if I think it's going to be wet or cold outside, maybe, you know, I might encounter some water, and I'm fashionable to the T, as always. But I'm going to put those on because I'm afraid that if I don't, I'm going to ruin my tennis shoes, and I can't ruin my dad shoes because those are my speaking shoes, you know. Alright, so it's like 3 in the daytime and I haven't had any caffeine yet. It's snowing and I'm outside in Holyoke, Massachusetts, going on my first outing. I put on my technical boots so I could deal with this snow. This will be Bama'S first snow. Bama'S first snow, and how I'm gonna handle this. Because I go out on these trips and I'll go walk. I'll, you know, walk wherever it is, enjoy it. This is a new terrain for me. So I'm gonna find me some caffeine and a Dunkin' Donuts and let's see what happens. So I have ran into my very first problem. This is a populated road and I have no idea how to cross the road with piles of snow on the other side.
First caffeine of the day. Caramel macchiato. Delicious. Skim milk, save the calories.
Alright, so I enjoyed my coffee quietly and did a little bit of work for my phone. And then I had to cross back across that same big, busy road. And dude, I had another group of two people let me cross the road. So far, 10 out of 10, the people here in Massachusetts. You guys are really nice. I'll talk, definitely, with a little bit of, you know, some nasally voice, if you know what I'm saying. It's okay, they pick on me too, because you can definitely tell that I'm not from around here. So we just drove to the gym. It was about an hour from where we're staying at to the gym. Drove to the gym where the seminar is going to be held. And about to get a little pump. Woke up this morning at 4. Got on the planes and everything. So pretty tired. But, you know, I love training. I always feel better after training. So I'll probably get a little bit more energy. Bang that out. So going to hit a little bit of arms. Maybe some bench press, close grip, start with. So that'll be fun, get some blood flowing, let's get it. So to get warmed up first before I start training, I'm doing a little bit of pressing, I had some curls, some extensions and stuff like that, just training arms. Probably like a more bodybuilding style workout, but I'm definitely gonna warm up my lats first. I'm gonna prime my lats and work a little bit getting my T-spine mobility primed and ready to go before I do a lot of pressing, because I found that if I'm sitting a ton, if I'm traveling, not only does my lower body get a little wonky, hamstrings shorten, sometimes I get, you know, my posture gets a little bit slouched, you know, from sitting in the airplane all day. So I'm just going to make sure I open up a little bit, get my lats firing and primed, because I found that usually affects everything pulling down if that lat is pulling out. So I'm going to prime those first.
Easy win, nigga.
You know what your problem is? You don't work out. Got exercise. Look at me. That's all muscle.
Oh.
You fat. I'm muscle.
Oh, look at my little Bill. He's a little Hercules. Show me muscle again. Oh, Hercules, Hercules, Hercules,
what you
Hercules,
work out?
Hercules.
Your metabolism starts to speed up. You can eat anything you want. Go on. Knock yourself out.
So strong.
Well, Ernie, recent studies have shown that certain people are genetically predisposed to gaining weight. Someday in the near future, we might even find a cure.
Only thing you need to study is your ass. I got a big ass. Your mama got a big ass.
Please.
You do have a big ass. Don't tell me nothing. Your ass is as big in our family. So you need to get used to that. And I don't care what diet you go on, you can sew up your stomach and your asshole, you're gonna always be fat.
Daddy, all I'm trying to say is that scientific breakthroughs are occurring all the time.
And the only thing about to break through is your ass about to break through the seat of your pants.
All right, so just got back from the gym and getting something to eat. Grabbed a shower and did a little bit of work. Now about to lay down for the night. It's probably about 10 o'clock. Trying to catch up, get some sleep. And yeah, we're leaving here at 8 in the morning to be at weigh-ins. So I'll see all you guys there. Can't wait to meet everyone. And then my seminar starts at 10 tomorrow. See you then. Good morning. Today is Saturday, day of the seminar. What a beautiful winter wonderland. All right, so just came down and smashed some breakfast. Had about 3 eggs, give or take, and some sausage and a Kodiak flapjack bowl. So made sure I got my protein in this morning, got some carbs. About to head to the gym. We're about to do weigh-ins, and then at 10 we'll be starting my seminar. So it's a good day to have a good day, guys. Update, it's still cold.
The wizard there is. He always gets lucky, and Hermione and Ron always bail him out, or some person bails him out. He literally does nothing the entire movie.
Sibby is over here trash-talking like, Harry Potter. What kind of wizard are you? What kind of wizard are you? What can you do, huh? Sibby, what can you do?
More than Harry Potter, I tell you that.
What kind of cool scars do you have? What kind of cool scars do you have?
It's
like not convenient, but
I
just had to
use
it. Yeah.
Hey, don't let me like run really loud with
those. Oh, it's not even if you're gonna do it or not. It's like just how fast you're gonna do it, dude.
Oh, that's really cool.
Dude, I'm with it. Oh, thank you. All right, guys. So finished up a long day. Long day. Today was a seminar day, but man, it was fantastic. It was fantastic. It was one of my best seminars I've given yet. Just really good group too, very interactive. Great time. You know, as far as the cold, it is really cold here. Like, and it gets really cold. And I will say, the one thing that you guys told me to do, that was layer up. You guys are the best because I had layers and then more layers and then more layers. You know what I'm saying? So, like, that was a big win. Thank you, guys. You guys saved my life. So, thank you for the layers advice. You know, I wish I did have a hat. Like, really telling myself, like, I didn't have any hats, but because this just really didn't cut it. You know, the earsies were a little bit, look at that, ooh, they're a little bit cold. But other than that, Massachusetts has been pretty cool. Emphasis on the cool. But it's been a really good time so far, and I'm really happy to be here. And I can't wait for what's next. St. Louis next weekend, boys. Woo! What a wild world. I'm just gonna update you guys. It is cold here. It is very cold here. It's 11 degrees. This is definitely not Florida anymore, Dorothy. We're not in Florida anymore. Let's go, Sibia! Hello there. So, made it to the airport, about to fly out, get on the bird, headed back to Florida where it is warm. Made it through CSA, pleasant day, got the pat down, brought up some funky colors in the groin. You know what time it is? Got a little toast rubbing down there. Sometime be breathing fire out here in this cold weather. Get money, we made it through, so it's time to get on the bird. Chula, my current diet is bacon, egg, and cheese croissants.